Hello guys, welcome to the Hindu Editorial Analysis by English Club. So I'd be discussing on yesterday's, that is 30th November's editorial, okay? So as of now, I'd be telling you, I found three or four passages worth reading, okay? So how to select the number of, how to select the topics I had already told you in the last video. If haven't, you haven't viewed it, please view it first. And then today I'll be telling you you don't have to read the whole article or the whole passages, which is about 200 length, like this passage, The Case for Progressive International. This is a whole big passage, okay, about 200 words length. So you don't need to read the whole thing. So how to read it, okay? Just in order to have the core concept, short summary, just read three or four paragraphs and then get the knack of it and move on to the next passage, okay? So how to discover things, how to get to know as to which passage will involve your core thinking, your critical thinking, and your analytical thinking, okay? So like I found this number theory very useful, okay? This number theory is about a reaccounting thing which is done right now by the BJP led government about some past relating to the accounting of that was done in the UPS time, okay? And this has presented very surprising pictures, like the UPA government had told that India was riding on growth, okay? India achieved far superior growth prospects in those times. So this picture is presenting somewhat false claims, okay? And how this picture is not taken into good how this picture is again, is creating controversies in the political realm, okay? So this we'll be studying in this number theory. Then again, a really very good topic worth considering is cool it. So don't read any topic, but still, if you have no time, please read this topic, because, you know, this topic is again, is a very running on, current context. Current context mein run kar raha hai, environment, climate pe hai. It's about how rising temperatures, changing climatic conditions is affecting productivity, the world around, okay? And what India should do in order to reverse the process, okay? Like India should produce more electric vehicles, India should stop its usage of conventional fuels and, you know, focus more on fuel efficient options. And so the next passage I found worth again reading was Sabarimala politics. So Sabarimala politics is about, again, this is a religio-political passage, but still I'm telling you to read, because, you know, there are some passages which will include good number of vocabularies, good number of usage of phrases and idioms. So you do need to increase your vocabulary level day by day, okay? So for doing that, please read that topic and don't read it from the context of engrossing yourself into politics, into the realm of politics, or even having a secular mindset. Don't read from that mindset. Read from the mindset of developing your reading skills, okay? So because if you read from that mindset, again, you will, you know, go somewhere else, in some other world, okay? So you don't have to go in some other world. You just have to develop your core concept, your vocabularies, and your agenda of reading. So the next topic is somewhat bigger, but still I'm telling you, this is Walking by the Tightrope. It's about how US has lifted sanctions. Sanctions is a penalty jo ki US ke dwara abhi lift kar diya gaya hai, rok diya gaya hai, taki India and other seven countries can start importing oil from Iraq, okay? So it's about that topic. Then don't read the whole passage. It's again a 200 words length, but still read only few paragraphs, three or four paragraphs, just to know, get to know as to the core concept, okay? So The Case for Progressive International mein arbitration pe tha. Arbitration is a dispute. So we have, India is involved into international trade with other countries also, okay? So what if a dispute arises, like India-China trade? So India-China trade mein agar dispute arise hoga, to usko kaun dekhega? India dekhega, China dekhega? Dono mein se koi bhi nahi dekhenge, kyunki agar dono mein se koi ek dekhenge, to usme partial twist aa jayega. So partiality will be there. So ek third independent agency hota hai, jo ki डिस्प्यूट को ट्रीट करता है, एंड दैट इज आर्बिट्रेशन. एंड हाउ इंडिया इज इन्वॉल्व इन टू दीज आर्बिट्रेशंस, दीज डिस्प्यूट्स, एंड वॉट विल बी इट्स इम्प्लीकेशंस और इट्स इफेक्ट ऑन इट्स फर्दर ट्रेड. So this is all about, again, a core concept about how India is dealing trade and how it is involved in these arbitrations. So it's again a new word for you and a new concept. So again, a new concept comes, just grasp it and just grasp the core concept and move on. Don't get into the nitty-gritties. So the number theory. Let's begin. The number theory is about a. So again, it begins with the. So see again, the it begins with the word backcasting. And as of now, backcasting is again a verbiage or a technical term. See, but it is separated by, but it is again, we have a comma after that, or. So if I say Ram or Shyam, so it means either Ram or Shyam, not both. Okay, so backcasting or again, so the statement which will be coming again is the definition of the word backcasting. So what is backcasting? It's a reworking of past national accounts statistics based on the latest base year. So it's again a reaccounting of the national accounts statistics based on the latest base year. It's again a reaccounting thing. Is a regular exercise that governments carry out. So this is something which a regular exercise, okay, mainly done to enable precise comparison and analysis. And this backcasting is done for precise comparison, that is correct comparison. It is a difficult exercise prone to contestation. Why is it? So it is a difficult exercise prone to contestation means there are various, pros and cons. Like some people will say that it is wrong, some people say that it is right, okay. As it involves the inclusion of newer data. So why it is prone to contestation? Point one, because it involves an inclusion of newer data. So it says point number two, exclusion of outdated ones. Point number three, and making some subjective assumptions in the process. Okay. So that is why it is prone to contestation. Like people can challenge things because it includes newer data, it excludes old data, and makes some subjective assumptions on the in the process. Throw in the political realm. And GDP backcasting can become a controversial exercise. So if we throw in political side, if we look from the political angle, the GDP backcasting can become a controversial exercise. So why not? So current BJP government is taking out certain work of UPA time frames, and it is doing some reaccounting, and then it is saying that whatever UPA government did, whatever accounting outcome UPA government presented was entirely wrong, okay, and India was not at all riding on high growth prospects. So this is again something, so that is why it is controversial, because so it is a controversial, and it has now become, in the case of the release of back series data, so and it has now become as it has now become controversial, okay. The data computed by the CSO and released by Niti Aayog show that India never really grew in double digits. So that is why it is controversial, okay. Because the data showed that India never really grew in double digits. So this is CSO's data, that India never really grew on double digits, nor was it in the high growth economy in the 5 years preceding this as earlier thought to be. So neither grew nor, so it neither grew nor in the high growth economy in the 5 years, okay. So nothing right was presented. It so happens that this period covers the two terms of the Congress led UPA alliance, and the new data have predictably set off a political storm. So agar BJP government is questioning some results of UPA government, so obviously political angle se usko sahi nahi dekha jayega, okay. There will be questions, so that is why there will be controversy, okay. The Congress may feel aggrieved. So what is this aggrieved? Aggrieved, agitated, or feeling cheated, okay, as its biggest achievement, because its biggest achievement of taking India on the high GDP growth path has come under question. So correct. So such jitna bhi mehnat kiya gaya Congress ke dwara aur dikhaya gaya tha ki India is going on high GDP growth rate is all turning into false claims by the BJP government. So that is why Congress is feeling cheated, okay. During early instances of backcasting of GDP data, the political environment was not as deeply polarized as it is now, and so the exercise remains more academic. So pehle bhi kaha raha hai, ye kaha isme kaha ja raha hai ki pehle bhi ye backcasting hota tha, lekin pehle jo hai it was not as deeply polarized. Is had tak usko polarized means charged, इस हद तक इस लेवल तक एक्सट्रीमिटी एक्सट्रीमिटी ऑफ इवेंट्स नहीं हुआ था जो इस बार हुआ है. ओके, नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ. द डेंजर इन द पॉलिटिकल स्लग फेस्ट. सो वॉट इज स्लग फेस्ट? स्लग फेस्ट इज अ टफ चैलेंजिंग कॉन्टेस्ट, स्पेशली इन स्पोर्ट्स एंड और वी कैन से इलेक्शन. सो इट्स अ टफ कॉन्टेस्ट. द डेंजर इन द पॉलिटिकल स्लग फेस्ट इज नाउ इज दैट द मेनी वैल्यूबल इंसाइट्स दैट कैन बी ग्लीन फ्रॉम द डेटा विल बी ऑफ लॉस. सो ऑब्वियसली अगर UPA के डेटाज को BJP गलत बता रहा है या CSO गलत बता रहा है, सो ऑब्वियसली जो भी BJP ने सॉरी UPA गवर्नमेंट ने काम किया होगा, ग्लीन्ड मीन्स कलेक्टेड विद ग्रेट डिफिकल्टी फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेज, जो भी डेटा कलेक्ट किया गया होगा वो ख़त्म हो जाएगा. ऑब्वियसली उसका कोई इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं रहेगा बिकॉज इट इज सेइंग दैट ऑल दीज वे फॉल्स क्लेम्स. ओके, बिगेस्ट ऑफ दीज इज दैट इंडिया नेवर रियली डिकपल्ड फ्रॉम द ग्लोबल इकॉनमी ड्यूरिंग द ईयर्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस अनलाइक वॉट वॉज अर्लियर बिलीव. सो द बिगेस्ट फैक्ट इज दैट द बिगेस्ट थिंग विच विल बी विच UPA गवर्नमेंट विल बी लूजिंग इज दैट हाउ इट शोड इंडिया falsely to be riding on the path of high growth rate. Okay, the new back series data show a much lower growth rate. So this new back series show a much lower growth rate compared to what it was shown by the UPA government. Okay, so lower, again a comparison. So whenever a comparative version comes, so it will obviously show comparison. This is an important learning for policy makers going forward. Okay, so this is an important learning point. Any criticism of the data has to be taken into account the fact that it has been generated by a thoroughly professional organization. The CSO and the methods have been scrutinized by experts. Okay, so it says that this is altogether an important learning. Okay, but any criticism, okay, so it's any criticism of the data, so although it has produced very striking or very surprising results that all the data of UPA government were false. So, but all these are good things, like all these are different things, but whatever the data has CSO presented this time, okay, must be viewed in the context that these data are presented by, you know, professional accountants and chief statisticians, okay, and these cannot be wrong according to the author. Certainly the release of back series by the Niti Aayog goes against convention. Certainly the release of back series, so if I say ki again agle saal kiski government banegi ye nahi pata, lekin abhi government BJP government ne ye result diya, agle saal kisi aur ki government banegi 19 mein, and then that government, if it comes out to be UPA, so वो again अपना एक अलग reaccounting से picture लाएगा और वो बोलेगा कि जो भी BJP ने किया था वो एक political angle से किया था. तो ये again, this is a wrong conception. Conception is convention. Convention is a practice, okay? Practice or established belief. This is a wrong convention, okay? And it's bad in optics, in vision. Optics is vision. So these conventions, these practices, so the author is saying that these practices are altogether wrong, although whatever picture the CSO has presented is right, because these are presented by very big academicians, statisticians and professionals, okay? So इनको गलत नहीं ठहराया जा सकता है, लेकिन अगर ये प्रैक्टिस है कि फिर से रीअकाउंटिंग करके और प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट में बैड प्रीवियस गवर्नमेंट को गलत पिक्चर बनाना, तो ये कॉन्वेंशन जो है वो बैड है. ओके, ये प्रैक्टिस बैड है. बट दे शुड नॉट बी अ रीज़न टू कॉन्टेक्स्ट इट्स इंटीग्रिटी. ओके, लेकिन इंटीग्रिटी को क्वेश्चन नहीं किया जा सकता है. ओके, द मेथड ऑफ कंप्यूटेशनल रिफ्लेक्ट्स द लेटेस्ट यूनाइटेड नेशंस सिस्टम ऑफ नेशनल अकाउंट्स. इट ऑल्सो कैप्चर्स चेंजेस. सो इट कैनॉट बी इंटीग्रिटी कैनॉट कम इन टू क्वेश्चन बिकॉज द मेथड ऑफ कंप्यूटेशनल रिफ्लेक्ट्स द लेटेस्ट UN सिस्टम ऑफ इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स द लेटेस्ट UN सिस्टम ऑल्सो इट कैप्चर्स चेंजेस इन द इकॉनमी. सो रीजन वाई इट कैनॉट बी पुट इन टू क्वेश्चन. ओके, now data sources have also been updated. Okay, experts had testified to the robustness of the method when it was introduced in 2015, even while underlining that the availability of reliable data was crucial to arrive at the correct overall picture. So it says that ki we cannot question this method. Is method ko jo bhi method ke dwara ye रिजल्ट निकाला गया, इस मेथड को क्वेश्चन नहीं कह सकते क्योंकि इट हैज़ बीन रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एक्सपर्ट प्रोफेशनल्स एंड मोर ओवर इट इज़ अ ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड मेथड ऑफ यूनाइटेड नेशंस अकाउंटिंग प्रोसीजर्स एंड इट वाज इट हैज़ आल्सो बीन टेस्टेड व्हेन इट वाज फर्स्ट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन 2015. ओके, एंड even while underlining that the availability of reliability was crucial to arriving at the correct color picture. Okay, so it says.